here at the Watermill in June and July. It's about Laurel and Hardy and their journey from two different countries, from the north of England and Scotland and from the south of, you know, the deep south of the US, to forming this world-renowned partnership. What attracted me to the piece is it's a play very much about a double act and the highs and lows of a double act, you know, the great routines that we all know, but also the failed marriages and the studio executives. For aficionados or lifelong fans of Laurel and Hardy, there's certainly lots to recognise. And certainly musically, we're very, very lucky to have Richard Sisson, who is writing original music for this and settings to some of Tom McGrath's words, but also arranging some of the very famous songs from the film. So musically, it's a very refreshing and familiar evocation of some of their finest songs and musical moments that people will be familiar with. It's not as easy as you might imagine to cast those two very particular frames and those two very, very renowned people, because we don't really want to do an impersonation. You want to kind of suggest those people. It's not necessarily there to say, are your voices identical? It's actually about trying to summon up that very three-dimensional person. But we're very lucky to have Paul Bigley to play Stan Laurel, who I think Watermill audiences might know from Love on the Tracks last year. Paul's a brilliant comedian, fantastic actor, brilliant company member, and even just in conversations that we've had so far can really summon up that innocence that Stan had and the way that audiences take him to their heart. And then Gavin Spokes, people may have seen at Salisbury, he was Nicey Nicey Johnson when they did Guys and Dolls there a couple of years ago. He's also worked in the West End in One Man, Two Governors, taking over from James Corden. And similarly, a really brilliant comic, but with the kind of beautiful singing voice that Oliver Hardy was so famed for. That actually was how he first went into show business, was joining a choir that toured around America. So I'm really thrilled with the people that we've got on board. It's just two actors playing the most amazing variety of roles. So they play the studio executives and the moguls and the wives, the mistresses, their own fathers. So over the course of the evening, you think you've seen this amazing compendium of humans, but actually it's just those two people that play all those different roles. It's funny, sad, moving, uproarious, and it's presumably down by about 9:30, so I think everyone wins.